Welcome, it's Facts You Don't Know. If it's your first time here and you want to find out new facts that will definitely make you smarter and more, well, and first make sure to subscribe and activate the notification bell so you don't miss anything.
He thought he was just meeting a friend at the airport, but when he saw this man, he collapsed on the floor in tears. A heartwarming clip of two Down syndrome lovebirds reuniting after spending some time apart is sending the internet into meltdown. Nick Doyle and Gabby Angelini both have Down syndrome and instantly connected in April in Detroit, Michigan, while attending the National Down Syndrome Society's national conference. After hitting it off instantly, the couple had to get into a long-distance relationship as Nick lives in Canton, Ohio, and Gabby in Raleigh, North Carolina. The mothers of these two helped organize a surprise meeting for them after the pair fell in love after meeting at the conference earlier this year. Lisa Doyle, Nick's mother, captured the moment when she and Gabby's mother, Mary, surprised the lovers with a visit after being apart from each other. The emotional video shows Nick waiting at the airport in Canton, Ohio, thinking his friend would be arriving at the airport. But then when Gabby descends down the escalator with her mom, he breaks down in disbelief. He immediately becomes emotional and can be seen walking away from Gabby because he can't believe she's visiting his town. Gabby can be seen dropping her bags and running towards Nick. The happy couple then hug while Nick says Gabby's name over and over again. The mothers can be heard in the background saying it was all worth it. The surprise reunion was orchestrated by Lisa and Mary, as Lisa took to Facebook to describe Nick and Gabby as inseparable through the conference. But then they forgot to exchange numbers. Like a good little millennial, Nick went to social media and found her, Lisa wrote, adding, they started their long-distance romance via text and phone and FaceTime. The couple met again in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania in June for another conference, but were heartbroken when they had to leave each other again. Gabby broke down crying to her mom, telling her how much she missed Nick, Lisa said. Lisa said that Mary, Gabby's mom, reached out to her about it, and they both knew that they had to do something to get them together. So Mary booked a flight for her and Gabby to visit them in Canton to surprise them. Mary told Gabby they were going to a conference, and Lisa told Nick that a friend needed a ride home from the airport. This is Nick and Gabby's first relationship, and the mothers believe the couple are committed to each other to the point where they could get married sometime later. It's truly remarkable that their relationship even blossomed, as neither Nick nor Gabby have ever been in a relationship before, Lisa wrote. Nor did they have interest in having a relationship with someone with DS. But it truly was love at first sight. She continued, people with DS have no warm-up time when it comes to love. They lean in and love fully. I've never seen Nick so happy in his 30 years. We feel confident that there will be wedding bells in their future. May God continue to bless these two. The video of the reunion at the airport has gone viral with more than 16,000 shares since Lisa posted it on social media. Nick is a performer in the world's first all-Down syndrome improv troupe, the Improvineers, and Gabby owns her own coffee business, Gabby's Grounds Coffee Shop. But in spite of their busy schedules, the couple are going to meet up again next week. Fate again changes our lives in the same place. If there was one thing that Brooks Lindsay wanted more than anything else in the world, it was to see the delivery of his unborn daughter. The soldier had to leave his wife pregnant and travel to a mission, but he'd planned to be home 2 weeks before the day of his daughter's scheduled delivery. But often the way it is with plans, things took a cruel twist that saw the wife deliver without him. Brooks had made plans to travel at least 2 weeks before the baby arrived so that he could help his wife get ready for the delivery. However, his wife suffered from preeclampsia and the baby was under stress. This had made it necessary to induce her labor 2 weeks before the delivery date so that the doctors could save the lives of both mother and baby. This being the case, Brooks quickly scheduled a flight to Mississippi 2 weeks early so that he would at least be present during the wife's delivery. Unfortunately, his wife went into labor when he was at the airport, waiting to board his flight, which had now been delayed for 2 hours. His heart was filled with disappointment, but he couldn't believe what was happening. He would not be able to witness the birth of his first child. His mother was going to be present during the delivery. She knew how disappointed her son would be if he missed the birth, so she hid her phone and then took it into the delivery room. Once there, she FaceTimed him so that he could watch the delivery from the airport. The distraught soldier suddenly lit up. This was better than missing the birth entirely. He found a nice corner and sat against the wall as he watched his daughter enter the world. His face was lined with pure emotion as he watched his poor wife struggle to give birth to his daughter. His flight was cleared just as the baby was coming through. It was such an emotional moment, and he couldn't hold back tears of joy. His baby girl was finally here. The airport staff was pushing him to board the flight, unaware of what was going on. It was at that moment that the delivering doctor shouted, "Don't let him board that plane. She's here. She's here." The staff looked at his phone, only to realize that the emotional man had been watching the delivery the whole time. They decided to leave him alone to enjoy the special moment in peace. A few minutes later, word would spread throughout the entire airport, and everyone knew what was going on. Tracy Dover had taken a video of the lone soldier, who was seated on the floor with his back against the wall and his eyes glued to his phone screen. She then took to social media, where she posted the photo and wrote his story. She said that everybody at the airport was happy for him. She was hoping to remind the people that the brave men who fight to keep us safe each day needed to be appreciated for all they've sacrificed. The photo quickly went viral on social media and garnered thousands of likes and shares in a day. Brooks finally boarded the plane and went home to his wife and daughter. He held the little angel in his arms and was so glad that he was now home. He was now a father. Thanks for watching. Please like and share the video in social networks. We'll be right back to you as fast as we can.